Hello and welcome to a new, I'd call it a mini series, Minecraft Basics. This is meant for those of you who have just purchased Minecraft or are about to purchase Minecraft, and you're trying to figure out how to play this thing, what to do when you first arrive in a survival world, which we are in right now. This is a fresh world, just generated. And I have absolutely nothing right now. So it's daytime, and oh, I should have turned on. Let me see. Let's make it easy. So we get after dark, especially, we will get some mobs. Anyway, the first thing you want to do is punch wood, of which we have a fair bit. So let's start right here. Because you have to start, and then it's a slow process, but get a few pieces of wood here. That's the first thing you start in any survival, that you start completely blank. Let's definitely get some wood together. One more. Might as well, I can reach it anyway. And the leaves will decay automatically, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, that should do it. Let's go over here. Get this grass out of here. Oh, by the way, when you smash grass, you get seeds here and there, and you'll be able to grow wheat later on, but that comes later. So, let me open the inventory. Let's put the seeds away. And these oak logs we will change into planks, and then we take four planks and we get, yep, a crafting table. So we put this down, oh, right here. We open that up. Now we have a much larger area to work with. So now we're going to make sticks, just a few. Well, actually, we can have several. Like so. And let's move this up here. We put the sticks down to make tools, which will be something that's very important is a pickaxe. We'll need to pick at stones. We will also need a wooden axe, which is important for collecting more wood, so might as well have two of those. And we will need a shovel. Shovels use up pretty fast, so make several of those. Let me think. That's about it. Well, we can make a wooden sword. There we go. And let's put this stuff away. And this. Okay, now that we have a few tools, we can go at creating the first temporary housing, which we could do. It's a nice mountain here, because we don't have enough wood collected as yet to build a house, so at least we need a shovel. What I do usually, we make our own thing. A shovel is for the dirt, by the way, and a pick is for the stone or rocks. So we'll dig out a small room here that we can live in during the night anyway, because after all there'll be mobs coming out, and this is something you want to do as quickly as possible. Ooh, we found something meanwhile. That's also handy. Okay, let's say this is our little room. Oh, it's actually open. Gosh. Okay. We have to close that up. Let me jump up here. Okay. There we go. There we go. Go back down. Can actually close this in so you're safe at night. Get the shovel again. Take this off. Okay. There and there. Now I'm going to go out here, use the axe. Destroy. When you destroy the crafting table, you get it back, so you can use it anywhere. So I'm going to put the crafting table in, oops, in here. And let me see. Oh, I know. One thing I want to do is, now that we have access to stone, I want to create some stone pickaxes, because they'll be a lot more efficient and last longer. And you can use up the wooden one, but then we go for stone. Also a stone axe would be good. So we're going to have to make some more sticks. Also sticks will be needed for, I can use that up. Sticks will be needed eventually for making torches. Now I can make an axe out of the remaining stones for now. Well, we have a backup. We can collect more wood. Yeah, I got a couple of seeds. I'll show you that later on about growing stuff. Okay. While we're at it, let's get some more wood. There's a nice birch here. It's much faster with an axe. Good. Now we have wood. Now I'm going to go down here. Since we're that lucky that there is a... we have coal here. Look at that. Let's see if I can get it out. Yeah. Coal will be useful for torches, because we definitely need light at night. So it's going to get really dark. Especially for this video, I'd like to have light. So, we'll be quite lucky here today. I generated this world a while ago, of course, before the video, but I didn't look for anything. I didn't know that these deposits were here, by the way. They're as much of a surprise to me as you, the viewer. Look at all the coal. Beautiful. If you look at the bottom of the screen, you can see the axe and a line underneath it. That indicates the wear and tear on it and how long you have before it breaks. Which means then you have to replace it. Let's just keep getting it. We'll need it anyway for cooking. That's another thing we'll have to do, is head out and do some hunting. You notice that there are some cows and pigs around. Again, a handy thing to have for food. And once you're more established, we can actually build a field of wheat. Never-ending supply, unbelievable. This is Minecraft 1.6.4. I think that they have changed a few things, like the availability of coal and stuff. It's a bit better than it used to be. I like the challenge of looking for coal and all that, but of course you can't always find it. It's not that easy. See the axe now showing a red mark below it? It means it's getting toward the end. You'll see it break as I continue. But that's okay, we'll use up the wood stuff and start into rocks. So you start, if I can recap, when you start first, you arrive in the new world that you generated. You go up to a tree and punch the tree and get the logs out of there. Then you want to create a, let's see what we got here, create a crafting table. And then you go from there. Okay, I want to do things here on the crafting table. Number one, we have... Oh, we need more cobblestone. Okay. Planks is just a single unit. Yeah, there's a good Minecraft wiki out there, by the way, for these things, so you don't have to guess. It tells you what's what. Okay, let's see. The light's going, so... I'm just going to grab some more stone. That's when it breaks. So you go into the inventory and get another one. Now that we have a stone pickaxe, it'll go much faster. And eventually we'll find iron ore a bit deeper down somewhere. And we'll be able to make iron tools. So now that we have sticks... We set them up and put coal on top. And we have torches. I take a few. I don't want to use up all the coal. We'll need it for cooking. So, next step. We set up a torch, first of all, in here. And I think we should put one up here. And one more thing we need is a door to keep the bad guys out. There we go. One door. So, here we go. One door. Good. Now, meanwhile, I can make this go around the outside. This the cobblestone, or any stone, actually, except for gravel, and you get a furnace. And we'll put the furnace in this corner. And the furnace needs coal, which we'll put in, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. Of course, we're not cooking anything yet. Let's go after the cows. We need some, there they go, a steak. Didn't get any leather this time. And well, let's go for the pig. And we get some pork chops. Whoops. Yeah, that's an uninvited guest. That's what's known as a zombie. I've turned the mobs on, so... Oh, boy. The little sword isn't the best, but it does the trick. And you get experience from that, and sometimes rotten flesh. Oh, there's a chicken. Oh, is it close by? Chickens give eggs, however... Oh, there's another guy coming. I think we don't want to be outside much. So, let's put the meat out here. Start cooking, because we'll need food. And we have enough stone. Oh, fuck. Yeah, that's what they do. There's two of them, yeah, that challenge is much bigger now. Once we have iron ore, we should make iron. Uh-oh. She's breaking the door. Shoot. Oh, where did we spawn? Okay, well, I've set up waypoints so I can get back to the latest. Teleport back to where I died. This is, by the way, Zane's map that you see in the corner there. That's a mod I've installed. When you're really new with Minecraft, I don't think you'll be installing any mods, but, oh, I did get rotten flesh. I shouldn't eat that, by the way. It's not very healthy. Okay. Oh, there's more of them. Oops. I'm gonna have a bad night tonight. Tomorrow, when daylight comes, we've got to find some sheep and get 3 pieces of wool and 3 blocks of wood, and we will have, I'll have a bed which we can sleep and get the next morning very quickly. Let's put this other pork chop in here now. I can eat because I've lost a bit. Take pork chop, use the right button on your mouse, and you eat. There. That gives us full health. Now, I was going to do one thing here, if I can find where my sticks are, and make a much better sword. The wooden one is almost broken anyway. Just sort of a backup. Let's try to rearrange things. Just because I dropped everything. But I was lucky I was right at home, so didn't really lose much. The rotten flesh, well... Yeah, I suppose we could cook it. See what happens anyway. Okay, this is done. It's a backup. Not sure if it will cook or not. No, I guess it won't. In an emergency, you could eat rotten flesh, but it's Not necessarily the best idea. That's a spider you can hear there. I'm not sure how long this portion is, but I think I'll leave it here. And we'll come back next episode. It'll be daylight again, and we will do some more hunting, get materials for a bed, and start thinking about getting wood together for a house and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's it for now. We'll be back with the second installation or installment very soon. Thanks for tuning in, and keep coming back. Bye.